Oh, that's good British style wrestling for me.
Yeah.
that. Lovely takedown. It's been a while since Jushi Liger wrestled here in London.
And used his weight on top of Liger there as well.
And it's
try and pin him now. He can't grab the ropes. His arms are trapped. Yeah, which is less pressure on Liger because that previous maneuver absolutely will weigh you down as well as your opponent. Deeds managing to get out of there. And now he's applying the pressure. Liger on the ropes. Very clever, knew exactly where he was. And you'd expect that with a ring general, with a ring veteran, with a ring legend like Jushin Thunder Liger.
Well, you know, it wasn't always that way for Jushin Liger. You know, when he first went to the first Japanese dojo in New Japan, he didn't actually let him into the dojo because he didn't. It's like a fairground, right? He didn't meet the height requirements. Absolutely true. 5'7". And they thought it was too small. Jushin Liger proved that wrong, I think. You know, the guys like Tiger Mask and Dynamite Kid popularized junior heavyweight wrestling in Japan. But Jushin Liger and his contemporaries like El Samurai and Rei Suzuki, Koji Kanemoto, Minoru Tanaka, people, you know, guys like that, they took it to the next level through the 90s.
Palm thrust that he.
That's right.
Very famous for.
A superhero from Japan, Hiroshima. It's a pleasure to have him here. I don't know if Dean Ormark quite feels that way at the moment to take some of those chunks.
Hiroshima, maybe. Got to have confidence from this, surely, because...
Acai moonsault!
The acai moonsault onto Dean Ormark.
And of course, Liger has had his wars with the innovator of that move, Ultimo Dragon, as well.
Ultimo Dragon, who we've actually seen here in PCW.
Wouldn't it be some decent Liger versus Dragon?
Don't think I could contain myself.
Basement drop kick. He's got him hung up in trouble. family proud. He's on the top rope. Double stop and oh, and he's nailed him. Did he get all of it? Didn't get all of it. Like a man who stops. As he appears, Dean goes up. It's beautiful.
It was enough.
Springboard moonsaults.
Dean Ormoc does not seem intimidated.
I would just say he's actually doing slightly better against Liger than Martin McKenna. Nice, super kick. Liger though!
Oh, but he's had that scouted.
Again, this is a tough player, Brad. Japan kicks out.
But the thing is, if you look at Dean Ormoc, he does use a lot of high-flying things, so you've got to say that he's probably watched a lot of Liger. So you'll be aware of a lot of his...
Oh! Oh, that for a backstabber. He's got him pinned! Referee Joel Allen says it's just a two.
Yeah.
Shot finisher!
Dean Ormoc is on the verge here of what would be a monumental victory.
Doesn't want to take that as red though, he's still got work to do here.
He's not going to try Brain Buster the Master. No, he's not!
Oh!
Brain Buster!
Oh!
Here comes your palm strike.
Yep. Yes, short tie. No. Drop two holes.
Beautiful, now he's going to get La Magistral. 1, 2, 3, and Dean Ormoc's been just hit on the line!
Oh, unbelievable! Out of nowhere!
What a victory! What a win! It's the biggest moment in Dean Ormoc's career! He has done his family proud! Brian Dixon, the godfather of British wrestling, somewhere here tonight, he's watching on! As you see, his son-in-law, the heir apparent to the All-Star Empire, and guys, put that empire on the map! Shushing Thunder Liger, and this crowd is stunned!
Not as stunned as me, that came out of nowhere!
Unbelievable!
I don't think Liger thinks it was three. I think he thought he kicked out in time.
I think this crowd is hushed, possibly in disappointment. Not because they dislike Dean Ormoc, but maybe because they love Jushin Thunder Liger. And they wanted to see him win.
Look at the look of joy on Dean Ormoc's face. And what a show of respect.
How much does this mean to Dean Ormoc? This is an emotional moment, Stallion.
Yeah.
This look guy, Dean Ormoc, he grew up. This guy, that's Mark Rollerball Rocco, coming over to the UK in the 80s, paving the way for what we've got today. It's a beating. It's just over faith in all Mark's career.
As he highlights a child in the audience who's wearing the mask of Jushin Thunder Liger. That must have been that shit sight. That's fantastic.